So what is Tesuji all about, and what was the 1-2-3 principle that we were talking about sometimes? If we calculate 1-2-3, play directly 3. Because this is the way, I mean, this way we keep the option of Atari from this side, and Atari from this side, we keep the two options open. It's very important. For example, if white extends now, then black can Atari from here. And escape in very good rhythm. With a quite nice shape. Let's compare this to the variation before, when black didn't know the 1-2-3 principle. Now when white no be here, black has to escape with this kind of move, which is not as good as before. When white extends, there's a lot of problem here. And also, this group is very heavy, now have to be very careful about this also. So this is much worse result. Well, for a player of our level, this kind of Tesuji is in our blood. It's like less than 1 second to play here. I mean, I planned already when I played here that if white cuts, I always have this Tesuji in my sleeve. And now, normally, white should play this. This is the most natural move. And now, black probably no B. This is a complicated fight, but the point is that this thickness helps perfectly black to fight comfortably in this area. And what looked before like a big white moyo now starts to look like it's going to become black territory. This is quite a huge problem. I think once he cut here, white should have fought. In the rear game, he did something very strange. Play here. At this point, I fail to understand what my opponent thought. If I don't ask him, probably I will never find out. I don't understand this move. I don't know what he wants to do. The problem is, for example, here. Later, black can very easily come here because he's quite strong in the center, and if white wants to defend the territory, then soon white will have a problem with his shape. This become bad shape. So actually, to close this upper side territory, white need one more move, something around here. But it's not even so big to worry about. So I don't understand. This also quite soft on this move. After this boshi, black can still easily play in sansan. I don't know. I don't know what happens here, but probably my opponent couldn't find another good move and he was at a loss of how to continue. I think in this shape already the situation is desperate for white. Because of his bad fuseki and his submissive moves here, and also his attempt to do something on the side, but taking gote, just to take a small stone and making black strong here, white completely destroyed his game. And now this kind of move comes because white is at a loss of how to continue. Well, I play this, and did I play this now? Not yet. maybe I play this also. Now, those are quite nice exchanges for black, becoming strong here. And now when black takes this stone, the side here looks open, but this Atari is anytime sente. So with the side closed, this is a very, very large area for black. Very, very powerful. Also, this stone now is too late to move from it. Black will just push like this, and this is already quite strong shape. So white is really at a loss of how to continue. So if we try this move, but when black play this move in the corner, it's really, I was really wondering, at this stage I just was wondering what kind of move will he find, because the game looks really over. I mean, if I would play here, probably I would resign at this stage with white. But Ilya is quite a resourceful player, looks like. In this situation he found this move, which I don't think it's extraordinarily fantastic move, but still, it's a fighting move that keeps the game alive. Black could have played very, very calmly like this. This is probably enough. We notice this empty triangle, which is a little bit unpleasant for white. And now, if white no b here, which is big, then black take the corner. This is probably enough for black. But I like center, so in this shape I choose to build outside influence. Now I was thinking too much. I was feeling too good already in this shape, so well, probably from this point on black's play become erratic. I have a really big difficulty to win the games when I'm too much leading on the board. I cannot find good moves anymore. The most natural thing for black would be probably to connect. If white calmly takes, then black honey here. This honey is quite important. It's an attempt to close this area in the center, but at the same time it's completely capturing white, which is very big. If white play like this, then probably some double honey. If white played this kind of atari and tried to break in the center, this becomes too big. Black can even sacrifice these 6 stones here. It's also very difficult for white to capture them, but this is already enough for black what is going on here. This was a very natural way of playing, but thinking too much, I choose a different way. I choose to play here, which I thought is more tick to the center, and then I have all kinds of sente moves around here. But this is thinking too much. Black is gote now. Gote sente is a really big difference. So, well, white got in the center, maybe not very fantastic shape, but still it's punishing a little bit black for taking gote here. And here is another sign of how good I was feeling. I just felt okay, just capturing this stone is more than enough. But just a little bit before I showed this game to my teacher, Saijo Sensei, and he was very angry with me because I played this move. What is the big problem with this move in a professional way of thinking is that this stone becomes completely a useless stone. It's a stone that should not be here, should be somewhere in a much better place. And professionals try as much as possible to use their stones to maximum efficiency. So of course my first instinct was to play here because this move uses well this. If white tries to escape, white black connects and this move is very important to win the same eye here. Also, after this move, it's much easier to enclose the center. So I really don't know what was in my head. I was so happy to play this tick move, but already at this point, I think my mind was preparing to lose this game. Even this nobi is much better, with much better effect towards these weaknesses in the white shape. But in the real game, I played here. Still, overall, white is in a hopeless position. Basically, he has 10 points of territory here. And here, difficult to count yet, but let's say 15, depends, maybe he can make 20 if he gets some extra profit. But around 25 points, and this shape also very difficult to calculate. It can be like 5 points, can be more, can be less, but there is a lot of bad agi in this shape. Actually, before going to the large point here, which white played in the game, I would like to show a little bit of these edges and what was my intention to play here.